Now, you mentioned 383 active cases. Has the local government actually traced each and every close or direct contact of these 383 active cases?
Yes, Christian. In fact, modesty aside, Mayor Benji Magalong cited San Juan as one of the better LGUs conducting contact tracing. And one advantage that we have really is we use a lot of digital contact tracing through technology and apps. And also because our City Health Office and the San Juan Medical Center are conducting centralized tracing along with our barangay health emergency response teams, we're able to trace them. In fact, one innovation that we've done here in San Juan is we released 3,000 pesos of financial assistance to positive patients who decide to transfer to any of our four facilities. Basically, this incentive is to make them transfer to our quarantine facilities so that we can extract them from the community so that they will not infect others, including their family members. Thus, the contact tracing becomes very fast because they really cooperate in the tracing process. It's really like an investigation. You have to backtrack who they were with, where they were, and those possibly infected by them. So I believe that San Juan has been doing a good job in terms of contact tracing.
So you actually give 3,000 pesos for every positive patient just to convince that patient to go into a government quarantine facility, right?
I would rather call it to incentivize it.
Yeah, not that's really incentive.
Because a lot of them would worry about their families, no? Sasabihin nila, mawawalan kami ng trabaho, wala kami ng papagkakitaan. So these are some factors that oftentimes discourage them. But given the fact that we will help their family, in fact, while they are in our facilities, they will receive free meals, that they have free medicines, their doctors and nurses 24 hours a day, and there's even free Wi-Fi. So we incentivize this so that they will come out clean and admit that, okay, they are positive patients. We've also passed an ordinance penalizing those who do not declare that they or their family members are positive. So they are all required to declare this because some of them are really just scared to come out and admit that they are positive. And now that we have our own mass testing facilities here, those who are close contacts of all of these positive patients are easily tested. We bought our own PCR machine way back March so that we have our own testing capacity.
Okay.
And as I mentioned earlier, the testing centers of the medical swabbing area in Palacio de Manila, where we have been assigned, have been locally transferred to us starting today. So we expect that we can do over 1,000 a day